In RetroArch, you can auto-patch ROMs without any additional software. To do this, you need to put the ROM file or the Rom hack file in the same folder as the ROM, and then rename the patch or the ROM file to the same name. Both of the files need to have the same name. Also, make sure that the ROM file and the patch file are for the same version of the game. Usually when you download a ROM hack or a ROM patch, you can see the version of the game. Now, when you load a game or a ROM in RetroArch, you can see the notification that the ROM has been patched here in the left bottom corner. You can also auto-patch with multiple patches for only one ROM. Sometimes when you don't load a ROM, it comes with optional patches. You can use this method to load more than a patch at the same time. Place the ROM patch in the same folder as the game. Do the same for the other optional patches that you want. Rename the ROM game or the patch file to the same name. I'm gonna go and rename the game name to the patch name. Do the same for the other patches, but because we already have an IPS file, we need to add a number at the end of the IPS name. In this case, we add the number 1 at the end of the IPS name, and for the next patch we add a number 2 at the end of the IPS name. And if you want to add more patches, you add a number 3 and the number 4 and the number 5 and so on. This is the original ROM hack or ROM patch without the optional patches. And this is the ROM hack with those two optional patches that we added. As you can see, RetroArch loading more than one patch. Just a reminder that not every core supports auto-patching. That's it for this video. Thank you for watching and happy gaming.